Good evening, live from this news center of the Sultanate of Oman Television. Here, we present to you 7 o'clock news bulletin. As per royal directives of His Majesty Sultan Qaboos, His Highness Sayyid Asad bin Tariq Al Sa'id participates in the 4th Arab Economic and Social Development Summit in Beirut. Future Vision Forum discusses in Muscat legislations of clean energy and supports small and medium-sized enterprises. Registrations for converting graduation projects in Fourth Industrial Revolution to start-up companies is to be opened in coming 2 months. And a witness of positive indicators for agriculture and fisheries sector in the Sultanate, and 270 projects are available for local and foreign investments. Good evening once again, and thank you for joining us. Those were the headlines, and now the news in detail. His Majesty Sultan Qaboos sent a cabal of greetings to His Excellency Andre Rajoelina, President of the Republic of Madagascar, on the occasion of him taking the constitutional oath as President for the Republic. As per royal directives of His Majesty Sultan Qaboos, His Highness Sayyid Asad bin Tariq Al Sa'id, Deputy Prime Minister for the International Relations and Cooperation Affairs, a special representative of His Majesty the Sultan, participated in the 4th Arab Economic and Social Development Summit, which commenced its work in Beirut. The summit discusses draft resolution prepared by the foreign ministers on 29 items on the agenda. The most prominent state on supporting investments in countries hosting Syrian refugees and accelerating the establishment of Arab Custom Union. Public Authority for Small and Medium Enterprises Development, RIADA, organized the Future Vision Forum related to electric cars. The work papers presented in the forum reviewed the regulations related to supporting the small and medium enterprises, as well as legislations of clean energy. The forum focused on electric cars, industries, and means of development of smart transportation. During the event, the entrepreneurs presented their points of views, visions and projects in the field of alternative energy, a green economy, and the 4th Industrial Revolution. The third edition of the program to convert graduation projects to start-up companies within the technologies of the 4th Industrial Revolution was announced. The registration period for the program will start from upcoming March until May 2019. This year's edition aims to find partnership opportunities among the Research Council, Omantel Information Technology Authority, Public Authority for Small and Medium Enterprises Development, Omani Technology Fund, and the National Youth Commission. Her Excellency Li Lingbing, Ambassador of the People's Republic of China to the Sultanate, affirmed that the bilateral relations between the Sultanate and China witnessed a noticeable development. She added that Oman and China established diplomatic relations a long time ago. China has been the biggest trade partner of Oman for the past few years, and Oman is the 5th biggest oil import source of China. The two countries have carried out a series of fruitful cooperation in the area of politics, economy, investments, and culture. The two countries have also signed a memorandum of understanding on jointly building the Belt and Road Initiative, which has built a new platform for pragmatic cooperation in all areas. Under the framework of Belt and Road Initiative, the two sides shall make the best of different advantages in capital, technology, market and resources, together explore new areas of mutual benefit and win-win progress, build a wider space and create more opportunities for the bilateral cooperation. The Sultanate and China also signed a memorandum of understanding to establish a Chinese industrial city in the special economic zone in Duqm in the governorate of Al Wusta. The city will contribute in promoting economic and trade relations between the two sides. You're watching the Sultanate of Oman television, and yet to come in our news bulletin, the construction of Shamukh complex for mining industries will begin during the first quarter of 2019. Welcome back to the news from the Sultanate of Oman television. His Excellency Dr. Fuad bin Jafar al-Sijwani, Minister of Agriculture and Fisheries Wealth, clarified that both agriculture and fisheries sectors achieved positive indications by producing huge quantities of agriculture and fisheries products. This came in His Excellency's speech for Economy Vision Program, which broadcasted at General Channel of the Sultanate of Oman television. Efforts of different investment studies by the Ministry of Agriculture and Fisheries Wealth enabled to find 270 projects, 160 of them are strategic projects, and 50 projects are mega projects in food production. These projects are distinguished by granting local and foreign investors trust where the government's shares did not exceed 20%, which indicates the stability of investment atmosphere of the Sultanate and predicts good profits. More than 60 million Omani rials is the total value of loans that were approved by Oman Housing Bank for 2019. Around 1,600 Omani citizens will benefit from these loans. Oman Housing Bank affirmed that the number of applicants for loans originally registered in the bank reached 6,000 at a value of 300 million rials. The approval of these loans came to fulfill the citizens' housing needs and the economic benefits like establishing the project. The bank stated that the interest rate of the loans ranged between 1% and 4%. It's worth mentioning that Oman Housing Bank, since its establishment, approved loans at a value of 1.1 billion Omani rials, and more than 45,000 citizens in various governorates of the Sultanate benefited from these loans. The annual plan of the state financial and administrative audit institutions for the year 2019 included tasks related to complaints that are sent to the institutions through a mail, electronic, or any other means. The topics within these complaints are related to violations of laws and regulations in force. The plan targets the topics related to diversifying income means, increasing non-oil revenues, rationalizing expenditure, facilitating procedures through electronic systems and e-government. It also focused on strategic projects and infrastructure projects within the ninth five-year plan 2016-2020. The Ministry of Manpower called more than 3,800 job seekers to attend job interviews during this week to compete 360 job opportunities provided by 58 establishments in the private sectors in various governorates of the Sultanate. The statistics pointed out that 3,000 job seekers were appointed, including 1,100 appointed for the first time during the period from the beginning of the current month till its mid. Ministry of Housing allotted a total of 36,733 residential plots across the country till the end of December 2018, which is an increase of 18.5% over the same period of last year. Among various governorates, residential plots allotment was the highest in the governorate of Dakhliya, with about 9,037 plots allotted during January-December period of 2018, up by 9.1% compared to 8,283 plots in the same period of 2017. The governorate of Dhahira witnessed a phenomenal growth of 212.43% in plots allotment at 6,005 plots. In addition, plot allotments rose by 28.83% and 71.57% to 3,856 plots and 5,859 plots in the governorate of South and North Sharqiya, respectively. Shumukh Mining Industries Company started the constructions of the projects of Shumukh Complex for Mining Industries and Dukum Commercial Tourism Gate will begin in the first quarter of 2019. The complex in the Special Economic Zone in Dukum, SEZA, is the first of its kind in the Sultanate. It aims to translate the directives of His Majesty Sultan Qaboos to enhance the added value of the mineral wealth available in the Sultanate and make it a tributary for the national economy. This would also provide about 700 job opportunities in the complex and 1,300 in the gate project. Watching the Sultanate of Oman television, and before we end this news bulletin, here are the main points once again. As per royal directives of His Majesty Sultan Qaboos, His Highness Sayyid Asad bin Tariq Al Said participates in the 4th Arab Economic Social Development Summit in Beirut. Future Vision Forum discusses in Muscat legislations of clean energy and supports small and medium-sized enterprises. Registration for converting graduation projects in Fourth Industrial Revolution to start-up companies is to be opened in coming March. And positive indications for agriculture and fisheries sector in the Sultanate are witnessed, and 270 projects are available for local and foreign investments. And with that, we do conclude this news bulletin brought to you live from this news center of the Sultanate of Oman Television. From me and the entire news team, directed by Musa Al-Nasri and Chief Editor Ral Al-Jardania, with the entire news team, we thank you for joining us. Wish you a pleasant evening and good night to all of you.